This is Neil Patel, helping you succeed through online marketing.
Did you know, Neil, that humans using AI outperform humans using without AI by a lot?
I did know that because AI can help you automate quite a bit. I do think there is one issue, though, which is companies using AI without humans. And sometimes it works, but in majority of the cases, we're seeing a lot of errors and issues, and then humans have to go in and fix it. But I think when you combine both of them, you can get more done in less time in high quality still.
And the reason we're talking about this right now is because I found a case study, and I actually read it this morning. And so this guy, Ethan, he put a team of social scientists together working with BCGs or Boston Consulting Group, which is one of the elite kind of consulting firms out there. And basically, they turned the offices into the largest pre-registered experiment on the future of professional work in the AI age, right? And there's a working paper that's out. I'm not going to read all 58 pages to you. I'm going to read segments of this post over here with some highlights, I should say. And those of you that can see us on YouTube, if you're still not subscribed to us on YouTube, you can see the images as well. You can now see my screen here, and where my cursor is, you can see that the headline here is consultants using ChatGPT-4 outperformed those who did not by a lot on every dimension, every way we measured performance, okay? There's a lot here. I mean, I'm not going to read all this stuff to you, but ChatGPT hasn't been out for a year yet, and we're already seeing a 40% increase in quality. That's just the very beginning of all this stuff.
Yeah, so the way I look at AI is people overestimate what they can get done with AI in the short run. In the long run, they're underestimating it. See, in the short run right now, everyone believes that, oh, I can use AI and just get it going in my marketing or my business, and it's just going to change everything, and we're going to grow faster and make more money and save a lot of cost. But when they try doing it, one, AI technology isn't there where it can just automate everything with a snap of a finger. It requires a lot of human intervention. And two, it's inaccurate in many cases. You know, I was reading something about ChatGPT and it was saying roughly 20% of the time it's inaccurate. But either way, it's not perfect. The way you can get it to work really well in the short run is you integrate humans throughout the process when you're leveraging AI. In the long run, though, the capabilities are endless. Just imagine having a robot like from the movie iRobot that's walking around with you and is helping you with your tasks or knows your life and knows what kind of music you like and just helps you throughout your life. I think AI is gonna really change the world in a much bigger way than most people think. But in the short run, it's not gonna have as big of an impact on people's business and marketing as most entrepreneurs or marketers think.
You know, I think this is a Bill Gates quote, actually, where he says that we overestimate what we can do in a year and we underestimate what we can do in a decade, right? So we've talked about this on the podcast before. There's three forms of AI right now. You have actual artificial intelligence, which most stuff isn't. You have augmented intelligence, and then you have automated intelligence, right? This would be a sense of a lot of stuff we're doing is augmented or automation. And Neil and I, we actually did a session, which we'll release in the next couple of weeks, where it's about 30 minutes or so, we talk about a lot of practical use cases for AI. Neil, what's one practical use case right now that is maybe not as common?
Yeah, so use AI to analyze your analytics data and figure out where you're wasting money and where you're not. Don't have it make changes to your ad campaigns instantly, but more so just flag it to someone internally on your team and they can review it each day. And that's great because it'll just help you save a little bit more money on paid ads and then reallocate that to places that are performing better. Simple. A lot of businesses aren't doing that. But if you look at how much money is being spent on ad spend, roughly $160 billion a year just on Google alone. Facebook's over $100 billion a year. There's more savings to doing that than it is to saying, hey, let's have AI help me write a blog post. Whoop-de-doo. That would have cost you $15-$20 anyways.
And on my end, I've been on this programmatic SEO binge right now. We basically will do the topical mapping, the keyword research, and then we'll design templates for those pages, and we'll just create these templates at scale. And then we'll use ChatGPT-4, and then we'll use a human in the loop just to kind of spot check to make sure that things look good. And then we're able to ramp things up there. Now, am I saying that works for everyone? Not necessarily. You're going to need a site with good domain authority and a type of business like, let's say you're a TripAdvisor where best places to eat or best hotels, like there's tons of permutations you can make. That is it for today. Please don't forget to rate, review, subscribe. It helps us grow more than you know, and we'll see you tomorrow.
Now, if you have any questions, leave a comment below. I'm here to answer them and help you out. If you enjoyed the video, like it, share it, tell people about it. Thank you very much.